Hello everybody, it's Xavius the Legend, and I am here playing Terraria with my good friend Toshwong the Wizard.
Oh, yay!
Also known as Mr. Fatscat. And
yay!
He's this alien fellow right here, below
yay.
Me on the purple hoverboard. And in this video, as you can see in the title, we're going to show you how to defeat Plantera.
Oh, I killed
and,
Henry.
If you guys are wondering, all of the items that we have are required, we did acquire legitly. And our house we built legit.
It might not look like it, because we played a shit ton of this game, but we did.
We've been playing on this world for, I'd say at least a month.
I'd say more.
And,
it's gotta be more.
At least a month or two, and we've acquired a lot of this stuff over time. We've killed, as you can see, all our statues. You have the Eye of Cthulhu, Wall of Flesh, one of the twins, Plantera, which is the one in the middle. I think that's Skeletron Prime, and that's the Bee Lady, and that's the Eater of Worlds. And also, we have this painting of the Destroyer, the Worm. So yeah, I'm gonna show you how to do it, and it's pretty easy. So let's go to the jungle and find our Plantera ball. All right, guys. So the first step you have to do in killing Plantera, of course, is to go to your jungle area, because the Plantera bulbs only spawn in our jungle area. And yes, as it may look like a blue mushroom place, this is our jungle. But with the gun we have,
Clintaminator.
Yeah, the Clintaminator. You spray it everywhere, and it creates a different biome from the one that's already there.
And you get that from the steampunk, is it?
No, you get
the
it
lady.
From the,
yeah, you get it from the steampunk. It's one platinum, one or two, I forget.
And then the blue dye you buy from the truffle, who's also in the mushroom area. All right, so let's go down. Let's go down in our jungle hole and see what there is to see. Alright guys, so the second step in killing Plantera is to find a Plantera bulb. And now that we're down here in the underground jungle, remember, because the bulbs only spawn underground, they do not spawn on the surface, you have to search for a bulb. And the best way to do that, my friend here is going to explain how.
Alright, so if you do, in part of the game, explore lots of the jungle, then you'll have a lot of the map. If you hit M, it opens the map, and so you'll see a ton. You'll see you can like click and drag to scroll around, and whenever you're like, just look around for little pink things, and you'll see them. And if like you hover over top, it'll say Plantera's bulb over it. So there's one right down here. I can take you to it.
Okay.
It is here to the left. That turtle dead up there? Yeah, he's dead.
Find said bulb.
And it is down this shaft, up this way, and right there.
Okay.
Alright, so now you don't want to hit these with a pickaxe.
So everybody, to destroy the Plantera ball, we do need to hit it with a pickaxe or destroy the ground below it. Something that you do with that Clintaminator gun, there is a bug, and if you make the biome blue mushroom underneath the bulb, it will activate Plantera. So now we're gonna tell you the third step into killing him.
We're gonna dig out the
area. Alright guys, so the third step to killing Plantera is to construct a battle arena. And note, this is probably the longest step. If the one previous to this didn't take you that much time, this will be the longest time. So the way to construct the battle arena is you need to dig out a large area and build a big, basically wooden room with wooden platforms all over it, so that you can hop around and get a good vantage point on Plantera anywhere it is. So,
and you
I've
just
broke
activated
it with
Plantera. Your pickaxe. There's another bulb, so we can kill this. And...
Okay.
Alright,
well,
so we'll just move to our other battle arena.
This is, yeah. So, if you happen to already have a battle
which
arena,
is down here,
then go to it, which is over
keep
this
it,
way.
You gotta keep it in the sight.
Yeah.
Or it will disappear.
Well, guys, this is the unofficial way to kill Plantera. This is the
unofficial. We goofed.
This is the unprofessional way to kill it, I should say. Because I was stupid and I accidentally destroyed the bulb. But,
this is what it will look like.
Ladies and gentlemen, hey, there's another bulb up here. We should just destroy this one.
Destroy it.
But, no, don't destroy it.
I know.
But, if you already have a battle reconstructed, you can go ahead and recycle it, as we're doing right now. And basically, the main way to kill it is just dodge attacks.
The best way is just fly around in circles.
Yeah, just fly around in circles around the guy. And
stay more
just
elevated
keep hitting him.
These little balls that bounce around.
And if you do have a weapon that does a lot of damage, like for instance, my weapon is the Razor Pine, keep shooting at him.
Mine is now
Plantera's in stage 2, which means that you can.
It gets them out and moves faster, does more damage.
Yeah, he can hurt you with the actual ball with his head, which is the mouth part. You just want to keep hitting him, you want to get a lot of DPS on Plantera. And you see that little puff of smoke around me? I have a ninja belt, so it allows me.
And we got a needle burst, which is like if in the starting stage of the game. It is exactly the same as the Vile Thorn.
Yeah. It's like the Vile Thorn times 3. But when you kill Plantera, all the stuff is going to drop. You get I don't know how many gold coins here.
Temple keys, gold coins.
14 gold coins, a temple key of lots of hearts, and I can't pick up this thing because I don't have enough inventory space.
That was the temple key there. The temple key is used in getting into the next main boss you would want to fight after this, which is the Golem, which is the final boss. Not anymore, actually. The final boss now is Duke Fisheron.
Is it?
He's a giant blue fish that kills everything in one hit.
Alright, guys. Well, thanks
do
for
it again.
This. Oh, do it again? Okay, well, don't thanks for watching. I'll thank you in a couple minutes. So, what we should have done is, we should have
made one
bowl.
Of these things, is what we should have done. In that other spot, we should have made one of these, which would have taken a while.
But,
and then this.
Since we already have about 6 down in this jungle, we can just run to the nearest one and recycle it, which seems to be the best option in our case at the moment. So I've run out of mana. I'm going to use my Mega Shark and load on it. My explosive bullets. So the main thing is just dodging, like I said, and doing a lot of DPS. So if you can do both at the same time, that's a great package, a great combination. Or killing the guy, or the girl, whatever it is, it's a flower, so it can be feminine. And
remember to use healing pots.
Yeah, to use healing potions. Your quick heal button is H, so I'm gonna go ahead and hit that.
But if you're playing on a console version, it is one of the directions on the D-pad.
Yeah, I don't know, this is on the PC, as you can tell. So if you kill Plantera a second time and dropped a bunch of greater healing potions.
Temple keys, demonic leaf blower, which is really cool.
Yeah, the leaf blower is pretty nice. I already have one.
You have one?
But it's at home in the chest, so I don't have it.
I got a hollowed key in my inventory. I didn't get it from that, but you can get those. These are life fruits, which you find in the jungle as well.
Yeah, and the life fruits, if you look at our health, how it's yellow, usually you only have a maximum of 400 health. And all the hearts are red, but each life fruit you eat, one of your hearts will turn yellow, and once you have eaten, 20 life fruits, then all of your hearts will turn yellow.
So here's another item Plantera drops here. It's called the Seedling.
The Seedling, and if you activate it, it spawns this little thing behind Mr. Fat's Cat, which is this little creature that's following
him. It's a little
him.
Sapling, dude. It's pretty cool.
So we haven't collected every single drop that he has, but he does drop, or she does drop the statue, as you saw in our base, and
he drops a weapon called the axe, which is a guitar, and it looks amazing.
Yeah, but it's a very rare drop rate. Anyway, if you want to see all of the drops, you can look at it on the wiki. I'll leave a link in the description to the Plantera page if you haven't looked at it already. And that'll be all, guys. So thanks for watching our tutorial video, and I hope it helped you out a lot. And something I did forget to mention is if you have a lot of iron skin and regeneration potions, or mana regeneration potions, those are a big plus when it comes to help killing the monster. I should have mentioned that before, but we already have Beetle Armor, which is like one of the best armor in the game, so we don't really have to worry. But it is capable of killing him, I think, with Shadow Armor, because him and I did it. Is it Shadow Armor or Meteorite Armor that we used?
I It was Shadow. Yeah. It was a lot of dodging, and we had like four guys.
Yeah, there was four.
And
of
a
us.
Bed, so we die and spawn in the same place.
If there was a big group of you, we advise that you make a small room, and you can put a bed in there, so that everyone just respawns, and you can just keep hitting the monster. Because as long as you're on a easy core, then when you die, you shouldn't drop all your items like Minecraft.
Yeah.
So thanks for watching, everybody. Hope you enjoyed the tutorial video. As always, like and subscribe, and we're probably going to make another video here on how to kill a golem. But leave a comment if you'd like to see that, and we'll go ahead and put that up right away. Thanks for watching, everybody. It's been Xavius the Legend and Mr. Fatscat wishing you a goodbye.